Hello everyone, I am Professor Amit Jadhav. In last lecture we have discussed about the C input output. In that we have seen the functions printf and scanf. So printf is generally used to print the values on output screen. We have seen some example how to print the integer value, how to print the float value, how to print the characters. After that we had learned about C input. So in this we are going to learn we learn how to take input from the user and how to store it in a program memory, and for that we use scanf function. And we have seen some examples to how to scan the integer value, float value, then double value, character, then how to read ASCII value, that we have seen in last lecture. So let's start with the difference between C and Python. So as C is a imperative programming language and Python is a object oriented programming language, there are major difference between them. First one is C is mainly used for hardware related application. So as we know that the C is a middle level language, it is like a machine language, also it's like a high level language. So it generally used to interact with the hardware. And Python is a general purpose programming language. C programming follows an imperative programming model. As I told you that basically there are two types of programming language. First one is the imperative programming language or the procedural language, and second one is the object oriented language. So the imperative programming language focus on function, while the object oriented programming language focus on an object. It allows the object oriented functions like class, object, then inheritance, polymorphism, that all are supported by the Python programming, but that are not supported by the C programming as it is the procedure oriented programming language. So next difference is pointers available in C and no pointer functionality available. So in C programming we use pointer to get the address of variable, so where the variable actual store in a program memory. For that we use the pointer. Pointer is nothing but the variable who store address of another variable. So in C programming, if we want to deal with the hardware, at that time we must use the pointer. And in Python programming there is no use of pointer concept. C compile and Python is interpreted. This is also one of the major difference between these programming languages. So C is compiled. So I think I told you the difference between compilation and interpretation. So in compilation, the whole program compile at a time, it find out the errors at last whenever we compile the program. And in interpretation, it checks line by line. If error occur in a line, then it shows immediately. So whole program compile at a time and it interpret the program in Python. The next difference is a limited number of built-in functions are used. So as the C programming languages was introduced in 1962 and Python introduced earlier in 1991, there are a lot of library functions are added in a Python programming, and that makes the programming language flexible. So limited number of functions used in a C programming, and Python uses number of functions, library functions are available. For example, math, then GUI functions that are available in library. Next difference is that code execution is faster than Python, and here slower compared to C, as Python has a garbage collection. So C is actually related with the low level language. So it executes fast as its syntax is near to the hardware. So it executed faster than Python. So if we write the program in C and try to execute it in fraction of second, it will execute. And if same program we write in Python, it will take some more time than C programming execution. Then it's a very difficult to implement data structure in C programming. While there are large of libraries are available in Python, so the implementation of data structure programming is very easy in Python. Next one, it's compulsory to declare the variable type in C. So we have seen the program, and in that we define the variable first. So if I want to define the variable C, I write there integer C. But we have seen Python programming also, in that there is no need to declare a type variable. So we can directly use and assign the value to the variable. For example, so let's see here the difference. So it's a font. I set it to 24 so everybody can view this. So here, if I'm using C programming, I have to define the variable after before I have to use it. So here I define the variable integer C, and here I assign some value. And if I'm using Python, then I can directly use the variable. So here we must define the variable and then we can use it. In Python, if I assign some value to it, it will consider that the data type of C is integer. Okay. If I write here 10.5, then it will consider it as a float. If I write here C is equal to double quote ABC, it will consider it as a string data type. So this is the difference between programming syntax, or this is the difference for the initializing the variable. So in C programming, it's compulsory to declare the variable, and while in Python programming, there is no need to declare a data type of variable. Just we have seen the difference. Then C programming syntax is harder than Python, because let's see, and Python programs are easier to learn, write and read. So let's see the difference why the Python programming. I'm giving you simple example. If I want to write a C program to print hi word, so in C I write hash include stdio.h, after that I write hash include conio.h, then I write the main function here, void main, curly bracket open and close, and after that I write here printf welcome to C. And here I use getch function. Okay, so this is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 7 line program code I have to write to simply print welcome to C on output screen. And same program, if I want to write on a Python, I simply type here print welcome to Python. So this program will give me an output on a screen, welcome to Python. Okay, so this is the difference. C program syntax is harder than Python. So here we have to define first directories, then we write the main function, then getch function to close the program. After that we get the output. But in Python, it's very simple to print welcome to Python message on output screen. Inline and assignment is allowed. Inline assignment gives an error. For example, we can directly cannot assign a is equal to 5. It gives an error in Python. Next. So here we and with the difference between C programming and Python. So maybe you think that why then we are going to learn C, but C is the very basic programming language, and if you want to give an instruction to the hardware at that time, you must see in most of the organization they are developing the games in C programming, they are developing some applications in C programming. So C is very basic and useful programming language, and in every institute the first fundamental basic language is C programming. So in this semester we are going to learn C programming. So let's start with the variables. So this is the major concept or the fundamental concept in any programming language, as variable. A variable in C, variable is the name of the memory location. It is used to store the data. Its value can be changed and it can be reused memory times. So it is way to representing memory location through the symbol so that it can be easily identified. So whenever we write or we assign some values to the variable, at that time it stores in a data memory. But it's difficult to get the address of the memory. It's difficult to remember the things. Suppose that if I write here, clear it. If I write here integer A and I assign some value to it in C programming, A is equal to 10. So when I write this line, the A variable stores in a program memory and it has a value 10. So as we know that the program stores in or the value stores in a block, and every block has some address. So we have to remember its address, and it's very difficult to remember. For example, its address may be 1001, 2001, or whatever. So it's difficult to remember. For that, we use the variable name. So we can access that value using variable name. So its syntax is type variable list. For example, integer A, float B, character C. These are some examples to define a variable. Here A, B, and C are the variable whose value is changed, always changed. So it is called as the variable. And constant is opposite to the variable. In constant, the value is fixed. So here A, B, C are variable of the type integer, float, and character respectively. We can also provide the value while declaring the variable. So if I want to initialize the variable with some values, I can write this integer A is equal to 10, comma B is equal to 20. Here we define the two variables A and B with values 10 and 20 respectively of type integer. Then I write float F 20 is equal to 20.8. That means here I assign floating value to the variable F. And last one is the character C is equal to A. Here I define single character because character accepts only single character. If I want the string, then here we have to specify the string value. So character C is equal to A. Here we assign a single character to variable name C. So there are some rules for defining the variable. First one is, a variable can have alphabets, digits, and underscores. So we can define the variable name. Here we define the variable name. So here we use some alphabets A, F, C, right? So we can use the alphabets, digits, and underscore. Only this it allows to defining a variable. A variable name can start with alphabet, underscore only. It can't start with digit. So whenever we write the variable name, here we write the variable name, it should be start with alphabet or a special character like underscore that we can use. For example, integer underscore A, it allows. But if I write 1A, then it's not allowed because the variable accept only alphabet and underscore at initially. No white space is allowed. That means the space between the variable cannot allow. You can, if you write there integer a space b, then it does not allow because it cannot consider the space in a variable name. A variable name must not be any reserved word or keywords, example integer, float, etc. We are going to discuss keywords in next lecture, but before that we must know about the keywords. Keywords are the reserved words. It has some specific meaning of it. So in here, the integer is a data type, float is a data type, and character is a data type. So these are the keywords. If is a keyword, while is keyword, do is the keyword. So there are some specific words that we use in a programming. It has some special meaning. So that keywords we can't use as a variable. There are 32 keywords are available in C programming, and that we can't use as a variable name. So here are some example of valid variable names. For example, integer a, integer underscore ab, integer a 30. I can add something more, integer abc, it can be allowed. Okay, then underscore abc, it also allow. Then some invalid variable name, integer 2, it's not allowed because it starts with digit. Integer a space b, it's not allowed because it has some space. And integer long we can't use because it's a reserved word. Types of variable we will discuss at the end. So it again types the same thing. Next one is the rules for defining variable that we already discuss here. Next point is constant. So let's see a simple example to define a variable and that we can use in our program. I think we have already learned a lot of programs, so you may be understand. So here I create the new file. First line should be hash include. Hash include conio.h. Oh, the bracket should be closed. Then we write the main function void main. Now we have to define some variable here. So I write here some valid variable. Its syntax is data type and variable name. So I write here integer a. And suppose I want to assign some value, I write here. If I want to define one more variable, b is equal to 20. Okay, I define these two variables. And suppose I want to print its value, here I write printf %d%d, comma, a comma b, and it should be ends with semicolon. After that we want to print the value, so here we use getch. We compile the program using alt f9. Oh, it does not give any error, and here we get the output 10 20. So here there is no space, so it will show like this. Again we get the output 10 and 20. So here we can use clear screen function to clear the output screen. Need compile and run the program, and here we get the output 10 space 20. You can modify it here also. The value of a is space, and here the value of b is, let's see how it works. So here the value of a is 10 and value of b is 20. And suppose we assign some double value, then 10.5 and 20.5. Or for that we have to double, and here we have to change with LF for float or double. Compile the program and here we get the output. The value of A is 10.50000 and the value of B is 20.50000. So here we can define the variable and assign some value to it. Next point is variables and constants. So next point is constants in C. So as variables has varies value. So in this program, suppose the value of A is 10.5 and 20.5, right? And if I want to change it, so simply I write here A plus plus. So it will increase the value by 1, and B plus plus. So it will increase the value by 1. So Alt Enter, maximize the screen. Here I increase the value of A and B, and then I run the program. So here I get the modify value, or simply if I assign some different value to it, we can. So if I write here A is equal to 20.5 and B is equal to 30.5. So initially the value of A is 10.5 and B's value is 20.5. And after that, we change its value with 20.5 and 30.5. I comment this line. And again, we run the program. We get the modify values to it. That means the variable value can be changed. Initially, it is 10.5 and B equal to 20.5. And after that, we change its value with 20.5 and 30.5. But it's not happen with constant. In constant, the value is fixed. So a constant is a value or variable that cannot be changed in the program. For example, 10, 20, A, 3.4. Generally, we use constant for defining the pi, as we know that the pi's value is fixed. It's constant. That is, pi is equal to 3.14. So for that, we use constant. So there are different types of constant in C programming. So this is the list of contexts in C. So if it is decimal constant, then its value may be 10, 20, 450, 460, whatever in decimal figure. If it's a real or floating, then its value may be 10.3, 20.2 or 0.6. Or it may be 7.8, 9.20, whatever it want, in the form of floating points. So next one is octal constant. In octal constant, the values are 0 to 1, 0, 3, 3, 0, 4, 6. That means the range between up to 7, 0 to 7. In hexadecimal, the values will be 0x2a, 0x7b, 0xa. For character constant, we use single character A, single character B, single character X. So these are the character. And for example, C program, C in Java point. So these are the string constant. So these are the types of constant, that is the decimal, real, octal, hexadecimal constant, etc. So there are two ways to define the constant in C. First way is using const keyword, and second one is hash define preprocessor. So using constant, we can define the variable const float. First we use const keyword, then float keyword, then pi. It's nothing but the data type then pi is the keyword that we want to use. Pi is the variable name. It's a constant variable name. Pi is equal to 3.14. So let's see one program. So here we create a new file. Or same in same file we do it, so it will save our time. I clear this. By selecting all and go to edit and clear, control delete. So first of all I want to define the variable constant float pi is equal to 3.14. okay, I define the value to it, and suppose I here define, or I if I want to print this value, I use printf function, and here I write the value of pi is. Here I give some comma or concat the string and give the pi variable, and if we compile this program, we get the value of pi is. Here we should write percent f, then we can print the values, right? Again we compile the program and run it, and here we get the output. The value of pi is 3.14000. So here I use clear screen function to clear the output screen. And if I want to calculate area of circle, so formula of area of circle is pi into r into r. So for that we required one integer r and one more float point, float variable, that is the area. So here we use area. And after that we get radius from user. So here I give message, please enter radius to calculate area of circle. And after that we scan that value. Scanf, as the radius in integer we use here percent d comma and r, we give semicolon here. So we scan that value, after that we calculate it and store it in variable area. So here I can use directly pi into r, small r into r, but this need to convert into float, so I write here float. So this float will convert this value into float because r is in integer, and after that we print the result, printf. The area of circle is, and here we print the value, area. Okay, and we compile the program and run it. We get the two errors. So area must be initialized. So here it's in float, so it must be initialized. So I assign some value to it, 0.0. Again we compile, one error is remain. Cannot modify a constant object. So here we get the error, that is the cannot modify constant object. So its value is fixed, so we cannot convert it. So instead of writing integer r, we use it. Yes, we must have the mistake here. Here we define the constant variable, right? So here we write float area. And integer r, okay, and assign some value to area is equal to 0.0 and integer r is equal to 0. Again we compile the program and enter the radius to calculate the area of circle. Okay, again we, so 3, and here we get the value. The value of pi is 3.4 and the area of circle is 28.26. So for that, as the pi's value is constant, we can use it as a constant, we can define it as a constant float pi. So this is a simple program. Then if we try to modify the value of pi, then it gives us error. So here we define pi's value is 3.14, and in program if I try to change it as a variable, suppose I write it 2.14, then it gives me an error. Yes, here it cannot modify the constant object. So we cannot, if we define the constant variable, then we cannot modify it. Okay. So second way, using preprocessor. So to define a constant, we use hash define keyword. As here we define hash include, same like that, we can define it. Just a minute. As a hash include is also preprocessor, same like that, hash define is there to defining a constant. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, so for that we use hash define. So let's see simple program. Here we define hash include stdout.h, and after that we define the pi value. Hash define pi 3.14, and then we write the main function, and let's see programmatically. So here before main we define hash define pi is equal to, it should be in capital, pi is equal to 3.14. yes, pi 3.14, like this only, and there is not required to define it here again. And here instead of using in small one, we have to use it capital. PI. Okay. We just compile the program and run it, and maximize the screen. So here we first define pi is equal to 3 point, as defined pi 3.14, then we write the main function. So here I commented the line hash constant float pi is equal to 3.14 because it's already defined here using define keyword. Then we define the float area and integer r is equal to 0. Then we get same program we have done, we just change this pi with pi. Let's see the output. Please enter the radius, for example 9, and here we get the output. So this is the second way to define a constant variable. So here we end with the variables and constant. In next lecture we are going to see data types in C. If you have any difficulty, then let me know now, or you can contact me on my WhatsApp. Okay, so thank you for watching. Here we end the session. Thank you.